All right, so is there one thing that you would have loved to have known before you started that you now know?
What did we say before?
That was hard.
No, I'm not telling them that.
So, Lauren, why did you decide to study chemical and biomolecular engineering?
Yeah, I was interested in a lot of things in high school. I thought at one point I'd become a lawyer or a psychologist or a vet. But I kind of went with the subjects I was most interested in high school, which was maths and chemistry. And when I came to the Sydney Uni Open Day and had a look at the engineering mini lectures, that's what sort of made up my mind. So, Tim, I have a question for you next. Mm-hmm. Who should study chemical and biomolecular engineering?
Someone who wants to make a difference. A mix of skills really makes for a good and successful engineer and a chemical and biomolecular engineer. So yes, there is some science, maths, even chemistry, but ability to work with people, talk with people, and have a passion for doing something exciting, that's actually what makes a successful engineer. So why did you choose the University of Sydney to study?
Yeah, I think before I came to the Open Day, I had a look at some of the university rankings and specifically for chemical engineering, and that all checked out pretty well. And then when I came on Open Day, I just really liked the feel of the campus, and being able to talk to current students really made me want to come to the University of Sydney. What are the entry requirements?
We've got an ATAR of 92 to get into chemical engineering. And that's not just for the single degree of chemical and biomolecular, but also if you're doing a combined degree with science, arts, or project management. There's a slightly higher requirement of 95 if you decide to do a combined degree with commerce, and that's 95. We also have a maths prerequisite because it's really important that you've got some fundamental math skills, and if you're a New South Wales student, we require that you've got a good score in two-unit maths, but we strongly recommend that you've done three-unit maths. And if you're from outside New South Wales, there's the equivalent subjects of what you've done in other states or an IB equivalent to.
How do interstate students apply to engineering at Sydney?
So if you don't live in New South Wales, you will need to visit UAC, that's the New South Wales University's Admission Centre website, and you can apply through them. So Lauren, what do you reckon have been the best aspects of your course?
Some of the best aspects, I quite like how it's taught in that we have lectures and then tutorials following up. And one of the benefits I think of this degree that goes for all engineering degrees is you tend to be with the same people every day, which is really great for actually making friends at university. You go to lectures together and you work in the tutorials together and you do group projects together. So that's something I really enjoyed. Can you do a major and what are the options?
There are a number of majors that students can do no matter what stream of engineering there are. But the key message is that you actually don't have to. If you are doing a double degree, like with science or commerce, there is not the space in your degree for you to do that extra specialisation. But if you are doing a single degree, you certainly can. But my recommendation is don't worry about it at the moment. It only reflects the subjects that you pick once you've gone into second and third year. Take the time now with your introductory courses to think about what do I like and maybe not so much like, and you can make a choice later.
What work experience do students need to get career ready?
Well, I reckon there's a number of things that that you need to do. And we've got a new program called PEP. And all of our students from day one, we're getting them primed to be thinking about how does what they do in the classroom going to contribute to what they're going to eventually be as a professional engineer. Now, all of our students, once they do get to round about third year, have to do some work experience of at least 6 weeks. But right from the beginning, we're giving you opportunities to be engaged with what real engineers do.
Next question we have is, do you have to find your own placements?
In principle, yes, we do have an expectation that you find your own placements, but we're going to provide a lot of support to help you with that. We actually do think it's important that not only is it the work experience that's valuable, it's the process of going through applying for things, attending an interview is just as important as work experience. But we do give you lots of help. We have lots of opportunities where we will try to connect you through careers nights, sponsorship days, where you've got the chance to meet and make connections with lots of people from industry. And we do actually have an option called the Jacaranda Flame Consulting Company, where we can give students their own work experience employed through us.
Within the chemical engineering department as well, when it came time for me to find my practical experience placement, a list was actually sent out of all the companies that other students had done their work placement at. So that was really helpful for me in terms of finding somewhere to go. How much time do you spend on placements?
We expect that all of our students have work experience that goes on for at least 6 weeks full time as part of their degree. Now, there's actually quite a bit of flexibility of when you can do that. Often you can do that in your summer holidays, but now with a change of semester dates, there's actually 6 weeks in the middle of the year over the winter break that you can fit your work experience into.
For my practical experience, I went to an engineering consulting firm, ICD Asia Pacific, and I was an intern within their process engineering team for 6 weeks at the end of my third year.
So if there's one thing you wish you knew before you started, what would that be?
I think for me, I wish I knew that you don't have to lock yourself into a career by choosing a degree at university. I mean, I was picking my degree when I was 17 and I didn't really even know what engineering was. And what I've found now coming towards the end of my degree is that I have a lot of options open to me in terms of different industries, as well as less technical areas such as management consulting. Okay, next question for you, Tim. Are there any scholarships available?
There's lots of different types of scholarships that are potentially available. If you're just about to enter engineering, we automatically give some scholarships to students with the highest marks, but we also have what's known as a leadership scholarship, which is given to students with high marks, but not necessarily the highest, but also through an interview process which demonstrates that they've got what it takes to be an engineering leader of the future. So what do you like most about living in Sydney?
I think Sydney's great. I think it's probably the best city in Australia, but that's my bias because I was born here. You really are with the university in the centre of everything. You're so close to the city itself. Newtown is also great. Like, there's a great nightlife and a great social scene in Newtown. It's a great area to be in.
So Lauren, do you know anyone who lives on campus?
I do. I live on campus. I've lived at the Women's College since my first year, and so by the end of this year that will make 5 years. I found living on campus really great, especially with the engineering degrees that tend to have slightly higher contact hours. So you're right on campus. If you need to come in to work on a project, you're right there. You can access the university facilities quite easily. And I also found it really beneficial to be a part of a college community. There's tutorial support, extra pastoral care, and other opportunities that come from living in that environment. Are there any exchange opportunities?
We've got a really ambitious plan over the next few years that we want half of all of our students to have had some exchange overseas. So we're really making our processes simple, so it's easy to see, find other universities which have got lists of subjects that reasonably map some of ours. And we've got students who go to all four corners of the globe, South America, Asia, Europe. We've also recently changed our semester dates so that there's an even better opportunity for students to take advantage of our winter and enjoy an exchange in the warm Northern Hemisphere summer.
I know for me, coming into university, the idea of going on exchange for a full semester or a full year seemed too long. So I was really excited to find a 2-week exchange program in Italy, where I went over at the end of my third year, and it was some of the most fun 2 weeks I've had, and I'd really recommend looking into exchange options. What career opportunities are there?
There's lots. Now, lots of engineers actually end up working in industries not directly related to engineering. But let's not talk about those. Let's talk about the exciting thing that engineers do. And particularly if you're in chemical and biomolecular engineering, some of the key industries that you get involved with are doing processing on a big scale. So industries related to oil and fuel and particularly food are some of the exciting areas where chemical engineers can be involved. We reckon that it's going to be a chemical engineer who's going to completely eliminate food waste in the world over the next 50 years.